Hello student, now we are going to study about geography paper first, that is GG201, physical geography, lithosphere part second. Now we have to study work of sea wave. Here we have to discuss about landforms associated with the work of sea waves. Then, the depositional features. Significant depositional landforms developed by sea waves. And these are sea beaches, offshore bars, then spits, loops, tombolo, tidal inlets, etc. Besides, swamps are also included in the categories of depositional coastal landforms. Beaches, temporary or short-lived deposits of a marine sediment consisting of sands, shingles, cobbles, etc. on the seashore are called beaches. A beach is a land on shore between the high water mark and a low water mark. Beaches can be composed of sand, fine silt, mud, clay, pebbles, boulders, and large rock fragments. Beaches are generally formed when sea is calm and winds are of a slow velocity. सागरी लाटांच्या निक्षेपणामुळे निर्माण होणारी भूरूपे यामध्ये पुळण म्हणजेच इथे बीच बीचेस सागरी लाटांबरोबर वाहत येणारे पदार्थ सागराच्या उथळ भागावर समुद्र किनाऱ्याजवळ साचतात. या पदार्थांचे संचयन समुद्र किनाऱ्याला समांतर दिशेत तरंग घर्षित चबुतऱ्याच्या पृष्ठभागावर होते. गाळाच्या या निक्षेपणालाच पुळण असे म्हणतात. तरंग घर्षित चबुतऱ्यावर लाटांमुळे वाहत येणाऱ्या पदार्थांच्या निक्षेपणामुळे बनलेल्या पुळण तात्कालिक स्वरूपाचे असतात. अकॉर्डिंग टू थॉर्नबरी, ए बीच इज अ डिपॉझिशनल फीचर अपॉन ए वेव कट बेंच अँड इज नॉट परमनंट बट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ मटेरियल मोर ऑर लेस इन ट्रांझिस. लहान मोठ्या आकाराचे खडकाचे तुकडे, गोटे, वाळू या निक्षेपणांपासून बीच बनलेले असतात. पुळणाचा विस्तार समुद्राकडे होत जातो. किनाऱ्याला समांतर गाळाचे पट्टे संचयित झालेले असतात म्हणजेच निक्षेपित झालेले असतात. लाटांबरोबर वाहून आणलेले पदार्थ व लाटांचा वेग यावर पुळणाचा म्हणजेच बीचचा आकार व विस्तार अवलंबून असतो. सागरात जेव्हा उंच लाटा निर्माण होतात तेव्हाच लाटांचे पाणी या पुळणापर्यंत पोहोचते. The strip of land bordering the sea that slope gently towards gently downwards from the land recognized as that part which lies between high and low water marks and produced by the action of sea. The extent and breadth of the beaches as well as their material largely depends on the coast. and the depositional power of the waves. Pitches are completely absent along the upland coasts. Along the gentle sloping coast, the beaches are wide and may extend for several kilometers and are usually covered by sand. The significant beaches develop on the west coast of India include Juhu Beach, along Goa coast, along Kerala coast, etc. On the eastern coast of India, Marina Beach on Tamil Nadu coast, Visakhapatnam Beach on Andhra Pradesh coast, and Puri Beach at Puri along Orissa coast, etc. are important beaches. During the storm, the waves are very powerful and may throw people and stones beyond the level usually reached by wave at high tide. This coarse material deposited along the coast gradually forms ridges which lie parallel and close to the coast. Then offshore bar. The ridges of sands formed by sedimentation through sea waves parallel to the shoreline are called bars. प्रस्थ समुद्र किनाऱ्याच्या उथळ भागात समुद्राकडून भूभागाकडे येणाऱ्या लाटा फुटतात. लाटांबरोबर बरोबर वाहत आलेले पदार्थ या उथळ सागरी भागात साचतात. कालांतराने या निक्षेपणांची उंची वाढत जाते. वाळू व इतर पदार्थांचे निक्षेपण किनाऱ्याला समांतर होऊन बनलेल्या लांब टेकड्यांना वाळूचे दांडे असे म्हणतात. लाटांद्वारे पदार्थांचा भरपूर पुरवठा होऊन निक्षेपण झाल्यास वाळूच्या दांड्यांची उंची वाढते. ते सागर जलाच्या वर डोकावतात. हियर द लार्जर फॉर्म्स ऑफ बार्स आर कॉल्ड बॅरियर्स. देअर आर डिफरंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ सँड बार्स and barriers. If the bars are formed parallel to the coast but are not attached to the land, they are called offshore bars. The ridge of sand and shingle that is formed in the sea across the mouth of river or entrance to a bay that lie approximately parallel to the coast called an offshore bar. Spits. Spits are formed due to the waves deposition. They consist of sand and shingle. Spits lie either parallel to the coast or may run from the coast at a considerable angle. भूसंलग्न वाळूचा दांडा मुख्य भूभागाचे संलग्न असून सागराकडे वाढत गेलेल्या वाळूच्या दांड्याला भूसंलग्न दांडा किंवा स्पिट असे म्हणतात. सागरी लाटांबरोबर वाहणारे पदार्थ सागराच्या खोल भागात न जाता किनाऱ्याकडे येणाऱ्या लाटांमुळे ते पदार्थ खाडीच्या मुखासमोर व बाजूस साचतात. त्यामुळे भूसंलग्न दांड्यांची निर्मिती होते. या दांड्यांच्या आकारानुसार त्यांचे वेगवेगळे प्रकार पडतात. त्यामध्ये हुक आणि कंपाऊंड हुक असे प्रकार वाळूच्या दांड्यांचे पडतात. pits here, the sandbars are formed in a such a way that there one end is attached to the land while the other end opens out towards the sea. They are called spits. It means that bar at one end are attached to the land and the other end terminates in the sea. Which is many a times curved or hooked due to the waves that advance obliquely towards the shore. They grow towards the sea side until the water becomes deep and the attack of the waves prevent their growth. A few spits are found along western and eastern coast of India. For the example, 50 km long spit in the mouth of Chilka Lake, Odisha coast, 16 km long spit near Kalinagapatnam, 60 km long spit to the east of Pulikat Lake, all along the east coast, 22 km and 55 km long two spits enclosing the Vembanad Lake. These are formed along the western and eastern coast of India. Then lagoon. The water enclosed between the coast and the bar forms a partially enclosed lake, which is known as lagoon. वाळूचे दांडे तयार झाल्यानंतर वाळूचे दांडे व सागर किनारा यांच्या दरम्यान खाऱ्या पाण्याचे लांबट परंतु उथळ सरोवर तयार निर्माण होते. त्या सरोवराला लॅगून म्हणजेच खारकच्छ खाजन असे म्हणतात. खाजन हे म्हणजेच खारकच्छ हे सागर जल सरोवर होत. लाटांच्या आघातामुळे वाळू दांडे दुभंगतात व सागर जल सरोवरात त्यातील वाळू वाहून येते. केरळ किनाऱ्यावर अशा प्रकारचे खारकच्छ आहेत त्यांना त्या भागात स्थानिकरित्या कायल असे म्हणतात. वाळूचे दांडे व सागर किनारा यांच्या दरम्यान खाऱ्या पाण्याचे लांबट परंतु उथळ सरोवर निर्माण होतात. या सरोवरांना लॅगून म्हणजे खाजन किंवा खाऱ्या पाण्याचे सरोवर असे म्हणतात. भारतात ओरिसाच्या किनाऱ्यावर चिल्का व तामिळनाडूच्या किनाऱ्यावर पुलिकत नावाची सरोवरे अशाच प्रकारची आहेत. The offshore bars that connects the island to the mainland is known as Tombolo. Tombolo acts as a bridge between the coast and an island. Lagoons are formed near the sea coast by the formation of a development of sandbars. Lagoon is the type of lake and formed between the coast and sandbars. Chilka Lake and Pulikat Lake are the examples of lagoon in India. Then mud flat and salt marshes. These are the areas of fine silt. These features come into existence in sheltered parts of estuaries and behind spits and bars. These parts are also known as coastal wetlands. there is absence of relief and sea water remains stagnant in these wetlands. Fine silt particles carried along with the high tides are deposited in these sheltered areas. Sometimes alluvium brought down by the river also accumulates. The vegetation also helps to trap the fine particles. Vegetation is able to trap the wind-blown sand, and this raises the surface of marshes. In this way, there are depositional features developed by work of sea waves. Okay, thank you.